May 22nd of the kickstart of Alibaba Group's annual Singles Day Shopping Festival, total sales surpassed $115 million. In 2 minutes, it crossed $1 billion, and the day closed with over $30 billion of gross merchandise sales value. Now just let that sink in. Appreciate the number of users, transactions, customer care calls, mails, and maybe hundreds of terabytes of data generated at an unimaginable speed. Singles Day is a clear example of success with data. Data by itself is of little use, and big data even more useless. Unless you leverage high performance computing, analytical tools, and artificial intelligence to get actionable insights and deliver action and relevant impact. Alibaba's Tmall, which is a B2C e-commerce marketplace, has about 600 million users, and they generate an abundance of data on consumer buying habits and sellers' marketing strategies. They decided to put this data to use in 2017, and as a result, Tmall Innovation Center was founded. This is a research and development entity dedicated for Alibaba Group and Tmall. Some of the world's top brands like Procter & Gamble, Johnson & Johnson, Samsung, Mars and the likes have partnered with TMIC to create new products and new variants for China based on consumer transactions and behavior captured on the platforms. Now let's look at a few examples of how TMIC used data to help sellers and brands. Now, Listerine is a well-known brand, but it was facing difficulty in cracking the Chinese market, where the users reacted poorly to its antiseptic formulation. So, Johnson & Johnson worked with TMIC team to learn that Listerine's target audience, the young Chinese women, prefer mouthwash with fruit and floral flavors. As a result, Listerine debuted two new products in China during Alibaba's 11/11 or Singles Day Global Sales Festival. Similarly, TMIC and Mars Chocolates, they worked together to find that Chinese consumers would be willing to try chocolates with some spice, and they launched Snickers Spicy in China. Now, from its debut in mid-2017 till mid-2018, sales of Snickers Spicy chocolates surpassed $1.4 million. Now, not just with the big brands, but Alibaba repeated this success with smaller brands as well. The watch division of Tmall studied consumer behavior of users and invited young watch designers from the Alibaba ecosystem to create and launch 17 new designs on Singles Day. So Alibaba Group is using data in three ways here. Number one, help sellers sell more. Number two, and these are sellers both small and large, by the way. Number two, help brands develop new products. And number three, speed up their R&D, innovation, and go-to-market process. Now, the story of new retail will be incomplete without AI. In the words of Jack Ma, data and HPC are the mother and father of AI. So AI, or artificial intelligence, helps Alibaba ecosystem in five major ways. Number one, recommendation system. Now, Alibaba has developed a software called e-commerce brain, which uses real-time online data to predict what the consumers want. And these models are constantly updated for each individual to take into account its purchasing history, browsing history, and online activity. Now, this recommendation system also works across digital kiosks and magic mirrors installed offline in delivering a consistent user experience. Number two is customer care. Any common queries and questions asked are automatically redirected to a computer system called Ali Xiaomi, or early assistant. Other than answering frequent questions and delivery status, it can also help users to find the right products when provided with a text or a voice description or even a photograph. It is said that during Singles Day sale, the chatbots handle 95% of the customer service queries. Number 3, ubiquitous personalization. What if each brand and seller on an e-commerce platform could personalize its store as per individual users' tastes and preferences? Of course, there would be a rise in conversion rates, and that's what exactly is happening at Alibaba. Number 4 is supply chain and logistics. From predicting what products will sell more, to appropriate pricing strategies, to inventory preparation, to best route and transportation for deliveries for both offline and online sellers. Just about everything a seller would want. Number 5 is security. Now, face recognition technology coupled with fingerprinting, pattern mapping, predictive analytics is helping secure the marketplace and instill more confidence in users. So this was the story and strategy of Alibaba, which is slated to revolutionize and transform retail as we know. And everything that we have observed and discussed in these two episodes of New Retail point to just one thing. Alibaba is poised on improving and unifying consumer experience and helping sellers become more innovative, efficient, and profitable. That's what we call as New Retail. Thank you very much, and see you in the next episode.